know what medicines, your phone, and your daily portion of fruit and vegetable all have in common? Let me explain you how they all rely on ecosystem services and the healthy functioning of our planet. Over 80% of our medicines come from the natural world, from plants, animals, fungi, and bacteria. Our phones include metals and minerals, like copper and lithium. These are found in healthy ecosystems. Finally, fruit, vegetables, but also nuts and seeds all rely on birds, bees, butterflies, and other insects for pollination. So without them, our plates would look a lot more different. So biodiversity plays a key role in our daily lives, much more than we often realize. My name is Julie and I work within a responsible investment competence center at DPAM, the asset manager of De Groof Peterkam. The RIC is a team of 5 full-time ESG specialists, all developing an expertise in our focus area. Personally, I work within the environmental pillar, and I focus on biodiversity and how to integrate biodiversity into investment decisions. Did you know that the World Economic Forum estimates that over half of the world GDP is moderately or highly dependent on nature and its services, like for example disease control, water quality or pollination? The ongoing loss of biodiversity therefore presents significant risks for businesses, investors and a wider economy. To address the critical need for a common and global framework, 188 countries adopted the Kunming-Montreal Global Biodiversity Framework in 2022. Many consider this framework as the Paris Agreement for Nature because it sets out a framework for action by governance, businesses and financial institutions to reverse and halt biodiversity loss by 2030. But integrating biodiversity into investment decisions is complex. Concretely, we at DPAM have been building an understanding of biodiversity and its relevance for investors while conducting research and exchanging with peers. DPAM is therefore proud to be among the early adopters of the TNFD, which stands for the Task Force for Nature-Related Financial Disclosure. It's a disclosure framework to improve the monitoring of nature-related impacts, dependencies, but also opportunities and risks, similar to the climate-related equivalent TCFD. In addition, DPAM is also actively engaging with companies we're invested in, because before acting, companies first need to understand how dependent their business is on nature and what their impact is on nature. In short, we want to measure it, we want to report it, and we want to engage about it. In conclusion, with half of the world's GDP being dependent on nature and the ongoing decline in biodiversity, our entire economy and society will be impacted. Therefore, businesses need to consider biodiversity in their business models, and we, investors, need to integrate the underlying risks.